I will be forever the myth.
You're the king of kings, though.
There's always a pecking order. The little peckers never mess with the big peckers. So I'm a rooster, and he's a chicken, so to speak.
I was gonna tell you, I was in that teenage Chicago, and it was in this gym, and they had us up against the wall, right? And all the judges were there in folding chairs, so they're like a couple feet away from us. And Norman Zale, remember Norman Zale? He was one of the judges. So they go, turn around and show us your hamstrings. And Norman Zale goes to the guy next to him. He goes, they don't have any hamstrings. And I heard him. He was like right there, you know. I'm like, what an asshole.
So close, you could hear him.
That's what I was gonna ask. So that Mr. Metropolitan, you went in the Mr. I think I was in the teenage. Was that where we posed on a freaking pallet and they had just the light and they had a powerlifting meet before the bodybuilding?
Oh wow!
I do remember that powerlifting stuff before the shows and.
Oh yeah, that was the thing. Bodybuilding was like, whatever,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
That's what's still like you're talking about. You know, you win the America. I won. You won all these shows and. Man, it's like, if we were any other sport, we'd probably have a pretty, big old crib and good
bank
account and you know, commercials and stuff. Like,
I know.
It's like, too bad it's bodybuilding. It's like, what, 1% of the 1%ers?
Yeah, we just did it because we loved it, man. There was no money.
Exactly. Yeah. That's what you're talking about. Because I worked a construction job in the summers, too.
Right.
I'd come home. I drove a truck, six-wheeler, you know, get up early and all that. And come home, eat dinner, be like 6 o'clock. And my mom's like, what are you doing? I go, I gotta go to the gym. She's like, are you kidding me? I'm like, that's what you do, man. It's gonna be luck, right?
Yeah. Right. There were times where I would train before work and get one body part done, work all day on a railroad, come home, and then go to the gym and do whatever else I had to do.
Yeah.
And liked it that much.
Yeah.
I mean, to me, it wasn't a job at all.
Yeah.
You guys
remember Phil Williams, the guy who won the Nationals in 85?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. I interviewed him. He lived in Missouri. And when he was a teenager, he said the best gym to go to was George Turner's gym. Remember George Turner in St. Louis? Yeah. So he lived like 300 miles or something from George Turner's gym. So when he got off school at 3 o'clock on Friday afternoon, he would drive in his car to St. Louis, get there that night, work out Friday night, sleep in his car, wake up Saturday, work out again, and then he'd work out like twice on Saturday. He'd work out once on Sunday, and then he'd go back home and go back to school.
Holy.
Sleep in his car in the wintertime.
That's messed up, man. That is crazy.
I would think I'd train at home doing push-ups, pull-ups, and whatever else I had to do.
Yeah.
But he had it. I'll tell you what, in person, he looked a whole lot better than he does in pictures.
Yeah. Oh, really?
Very, very sharp lines.
Yeah.
Very clean looking.
Yeah.
He was good.
Yeah.
He was very good.
It was funny, John, you tell a story like that, because I was thinking, you know, I trained, I did okay, won some shows, Then I listened away like some of the guys you've interviewed and what they did and how many sets they were doing and how they, I was like going, man, I didn't know shit. I was like, how did I make, you know, it's like my timing must have been good, you know, the right place, right time. And
yeah.
I was like, man, oh man. It's like looking back, I'm thinking, shit, maybe I should have eaten more, done more set. Just like, you know, you rethink it all.
Well, that's a good point, Larry, because all we did was just read the magazines, right? There was no coaches. Yeah. There was no Now, they all got coaches. Every one of them, they all got coaches.
Do they really? Yeah.
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 And they're on the internet. They're learning all the shit from the internet. I mean, we didn't know anything. We just had to learn through experience, you know?
Yeah. You want to feel triceps, you're going to just find whatever hurts them. And
stick
with that.
Right.
Let me ask you this, John. Is there anybody you would want to interview that you haven't?
Well, Arnold, of course. I mean, I'd love to do Arnold, but he's probably impossible to get to. But I'd like to do like Lou Ferrigno. I'm trying to get Rick Wayne. Remember Rick Wayne?
Well, yeah.
Yeah. So I've been like,
he was great back in the day.
Got to be close to 80.
Yeah, he's got to be up there.
But I mean, he was a writer for Weeders Magazine. He knew all those guys. He knew Arnold when he was a teenager. So I've been talking to him.
You and Arnold, you can't get to him without him.
I called his office once, but I'll keep trying. I'll try again. I'll probably have to go out there to California.
He's a superstar, you know. I mean,
yeah.
Let's face it, we all want to get over there and hang with him.
Yeah, yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Dude, I can't imagine his lifestyle, you know?
Yeah. When did you guys first meet Lance? When did you first meet Lance Dreher?
I met Lance, I think when, I'm trying to remember, no, I know when it was. I saw him at some shows, and then I think I saw him again when I, he guest posed at the Collegian Illinois, which I competed in, Mr. Collegian Illinois. And okay. I was like, holy shit.
What year was that?
I wasn't a Collegian Illinois, but he guest posed. And I was like, you know, the size of his quad or something.
Right, stupid. Right.
Like, Lance had a lot of muscle, man.
I know.
Yeah, yeah. And then at the, he worked for Chicago Health Club.
Yeah.
And I worked for Chicago Health Club. And then there was like a corporate meeting thing, and he was there, and I was just looking. It's kind of like you looking at Sergio Oliva. I was like, oh, I was like crazy. And then actually, Lance is the reason I moved out to Arizona, because we both were in that Mr. World in WABA in '85 in Massachusetts.
Oh, yeah, once, yeah.
Won Samir Banute one.
Won Samir one, yeah.
Yeah. And Lance said, hey, why don't you move out to Arizona? We could train for the universe together. And I was like, shoot, I'm leaving Chicago, and then, you know, never turn around. And we start training together, and yeah. Then he said, yeah, I'll meet you at the gym at 5 a.m. And I'm like, what?
How'd you do in that show, Larry?
Pardon?
How'd you do in that show?
The universe?
The world, the one that was in.
Oh, the world. I won my class. Okay. Marlon Dart won the tall class, and the overall went to Richard Roy.
Richard Roy, right.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. He was one I competed against a few times, too, and he always seemed to be a step ahead of me.
He beat you, too?
Yeah. He
two
he
of us
good.
Now.
Yeah. No, he looked
he got nothing.
He had a good look to him for sure. I think like the first time I went to the USA, NPC USA was like in 82.
Okay.
And I took third there. And that seemed to be as high as they would, you know, let me go.
Mm-hmm.
After that, you know, I took third once or twice, but I'd wind up, you know, going to the Nationals, and I'm pretty sure fifth was the best I ever did over there.
These are protein drinks, by the way.
Yeah, they look like it.
But then I went to that. Let's get back to Lance before I get talking out of my freaking zone here. The first time I met Lance Dreher, I heard he was working at that Chicago Health Club down 95th Street past Evergreen Plaza.
Okay.
So, John, you know, that's quite a hike from where we were.
Right.
And I, you know, I was young, 16, even if I was 17, I didn't compete yet. So anyway, 16, 17 years old, I took the bus all the way down 95th Street, and I get into that Chicago Health Club. I don't even know if I got to say hello to him, but I did get to see him. I might have said, wow, you know, hi, nice to meet you. But this guy looked incredible. When you're 16, 18 years old.
Yeah.
You're looking at this world class champion. You're like,
and he was young too.
Yeah, he was young.
He was big. Like, I mean, kind of like you in your pictures, man, that you've been posting. I was like, holy cow, 15, you had that big old chest frame and all, you know, structure. Lance is the same thing, man.
Yeah, Lance
had those arms that were just incredible.
Yeah.
And you were expecting, I mean, I think a lot of people besides myself expected Lance to win the universe like he did, and expected Lance to be a top professional. And,
right,
you know, maybe if he got there a little sooner, he might have done good as a pro. But the time he got to the pro ranks, you're running in these freaking symmetrical monsters that are, you know, ripped to the bone. And but hey, give him credit, man. He did a great job. He had a great freaking carried that so much muscle. I can't imagine having arms like that, you know.
Were you in the 1980 Central USA that he won? Were you at that show? You were in that show, right, Larry?
I was in
the junior,
won,
right?
I think it was a junior. There might have been a junior.
Yeah.
I think it was 80. No, that's
I think I won a teenage in 79, maybe, or 78 or 9.
Okay.
You won all the teenage shows.
Yeah, I
won
all, you know, but I'm trying to think. I did go into, I went into, Oh, it was, I think it was in Michigan, Midwest, Mr. Oh. Michigan.
Okay.
Same night, they had there was two shows, and I'm like, they're going to let me enter both, I'll enter both. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So I won the first senior regional that I was able to win, and it was really cool because they had those cool statues,
yeah,
which I wanted my whole life.
Yeah.
So I finally got statues because of the body parts and most muscular.
Yeah, yeah.
I won the Midwest Michigan, which first time I won a tall trophy. This is the greatest night of my life kind of thing.
Yeah.
But then the other one, which was the Central USA or whatever it was, I think I took second. Yeah, I took second. And you remember a guy named Gary Zuck?
Yeah.
Total Frank Zane looking dude?
Yeah.
Whatever happened to that dude?
I don't know. He was
phenomenal, you know? Never heard again from him.
He wasn't from Illinois, right, Glenn? He was from Michigan.
I don't think he was from Illinois, but I think he was Midwest.
Yeah, he was Midwest.
Indiana or Michigan, somewhere, I think, right. Indiana. But he had such a Frank Zane beautiful body, and then all of a sudden he disappeared.
I totally remember.
How about the one year I went to watch the USA, me and Schroeder, I don't even remember where it was, but they had that guy, Dave Johns, I think, won it.
Okay.
Not the big black guy.
Oh, that's what I was thinking of. Yeah.
This was a pretty boy, Johns. Was his name Johns? I just seen some shit today on it. That's what made me think of it. But the other guy there was a freaking powerhouse, strong, dense, real thick. And I'm saying to Joe, Joe's like, oh, this guy's going to win. Totally going to win. And I'm like, I'm telling you, man. Oh, Dave Rogers.
Dave Rogers, right. 1980.
I'm like, Dave Rogers is going to win this show.
Dude, you are an encyclopedia. Yeah, dude, you're the best, everybody, John. Man.
You ain't, hey, dude, I hope you got a lot of time because you ain't getting rid of us tonight.
Dude, he's already past my bedtime. If you were out here, I'd be asleep. I'm just like, how are you pulling this off? I hope you had a chance to eat because you just came from the gym. I know you
had. Yeah, I ate. I'm good.
John, do you remember who he beat? The big, thick guy I'm talking about? Peters, maybe? Mm-hmm.
I think Haney was in that show, but Haney got fourth. Great
guy. He had the long.
Oh, Don Peterson.
Don Peterson. Big, thick dude.
Yeah.
He's big and thick. It's kind of like.
How do you know all these dudes? I'm like, Jesus. See, you are the guru, man.
Yeah.
What's going on?
You know who took a lot of pictures of him was Doris Berrio, remember? The lady from Florida. She took a lot of
them. Yeah, I remember her.
Where was he from, Don Peterson? Somewhere in the South, right?
I don't remember
the damn name.
Yeah, no, I remember.
Maybe Louisiana or something like that.
That's what I thought. Okay. Somewhere from the South.
Yeah.
But then that pretty boy came in and beat him, and I just thought, I'm telling you, they're going to give it to that pretty symmetrical-looking dude. They don't want this big. I don't know, like a Benny Poda. Remember him?
Oh, yeah, I remember Benny Poda.
Like, dude, come on, really?
Oh.
I mean, I couldn't believe this guy placed ahead of me, I think, or even placed at all.
It was Bertil Fox. You know, he was like.
Oh, way worse than that. I mean, he had that shitty, you know, his head looked like it was going to explode. He made the worst faces.
Well, he would pose until his nose started to bleed, remember?
Yeah.
Oh, is that? Okay.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. He was
the beast from the east.
Okay, before we get too far from Illinois, though, it's like, do we not talk about Belknap? I mean, how do we?
Oh, yeah, we got. But before we get into that, though, Glenn, I want to talk about something you just brought up. We were doing bodybuilding back in the 70s, 80s. It seemed like the judges always rewarded symmetrical physiques. Like you had, like size was important, of course. You had to be in condition. You had to be cut. But they rewarded guys who had beautiful physiques, right? And that's something now that has seemed like it's gone away. Like if you look at the pros now, it's just about how big you can get, and they got to be in condition. They got to be hard as a rock, but they don't look at the shape and symmetry anymore.
Yeah, it's sickening to me. I look at a couple of those top guys, and a lot of times I look right past them. I don't even comment because I'm not impressed. I mean, sure, you want to look big and symmetrical like Coleman?
Yeah.
I'm impressed, dude.
Yeah.
You know, this is a bodybuilder that looks fucking like a monster.
Yeah.
Like that guy who won it, I don't even know his fucking name.
Who?
Way too
big, Rami.
Yeah, way too thick.
Oh, you know.
His legs are too fucking big.
Yeah.
But that's what they want now, right? I mean, that's.
Yeah, I don't like it at all.
I
thought there was a move towards like classical. Like, was there something?
Well, they have classic physique. So now it's like not all one class. Like before, it seemed like even in the Open Mr. Olympia, a guy like Zane or Muhammad McAway or Samir, those guys would place high because they had the symmetry. But now it's like they don't even look at that. So now they created a whole new division. So those guys, now when these guys are coming up, people will go, oh, he's classic. Oh, he's bodybuilding. So it's like, it's not all together anymore. It's just different divisions. Yeah, like so if you've got a symmetrical physique, you're classic. If you're big and blocky, you're bodybuilding.
Yeah.
Yeah. What's the guy's name that won the classic part?
Chris Bumstead.
Okay. I mean, I think he looks great, but he's not even close to Samir. He looks like an amateur compared to Samir.
Yeah. Yeah.
In my opinion.
Yeah.
Sure. He's in shape. He looks good. He looks like, you know, a Mr. Midwest kind of guy.
Yeah.
I think.
Yeah.
You talk about Zane, Samir, but
Labrada, McAway.
Yep. Labrada, McAway is the one I was thinking of. Labrada. Yeah. Now those guys, I don't give a fuck who you compete against, big or not.
Yeah.
They to me look fucking great.
They're balanced.
Right.
I would place all four of those guys ahead of this oversized Mr. Olympia they have now.
Oversized. Right. Right.
And then if you put them all in the classic, the kid who won this year, he's not even close to those professionals.
Right.
He looks like a good amateur. And I'm not trying to put him down.
Right, right.
I mean, he's way better than me. Say whatever you want to say. I'm just saying he looks like an amateur still compared to our greats that we see.
Yeah.
Zane, McAway, Banu, Lee Labrada. I mean, those guys are fucking superstars, man. Hall of Famer.
I just listened to this podcast a couple of weeks ago, and they got all these pros on there, like four pros at once. It's a real popular podcast. And the one guy was talking about Arnold. He said he was unbalanced. He said Arnold was unbalanced. I don't know what pictures he's looking at, you know.
Yeah, what are you looking at?
And then he said Zane was the most overrated bodybuilder ever.
Really?
Yeah.
Who is this? Never mind.
I mean, they're from a different era. I mean, it's all about size and
exactly
hamstrings and glutes and.
I've seen Frank Zane on stage several times. I bet you, maybe half a dozen times. The guy, when the lights came on and he was under there,
he was up there. Yeah,
he's like a statue, man.
I know.
This is bodybuilding. How could you not look at him and say, "Damn"? You think he won three Olympias for nothing?
Nothing.
Right. Yeah.
And he beat some great bodybuilders like Boyer Coe was great.
Yeah.
Name a few other guys. Yeah, they were great, but
kind
of like Lance. Lance was great, but Boyer Coe, he didn't even have abs.
Right.
You know what I mean? He had these great, awesome arms. He didn't have a beautiful looking physique.
Right.
And I thought Boyer Coe was one of the nicest guys I ever met.
Yeah.
Super. Yeah, he was one of the coolest dudes I met. Like Mentor, he was never in shape.
Yeah.
You know, nice shape and everything, but
John, was it Boyer Coe that you interviewed that got locked out and had to run around?
Yeah.
That is to me the best story. Did you hear that one?
I don't know if I heard that.
You gotta listen to Boyer Coe interview he did.
Oh my god.
He said he was
17 years old. He was competing. His dad used to drive him to all the shows in the South every weekend. So he was competing every weekend. So he's from Louisiana. So his dad drove him to Texas. It was like in February. It was one of his first shows. So there's all these guys. I don't even think it was a teenage show. It was just open, right? So he's pumping up. He's like into himself. He's totally focused on the show. So he gets up. He looks up, and everybody's gone out of the pump-up room. They're all on stage. So he freaks out. He goes out the door. He realizes he's in the alley. He goes out the door into the alley. All he's got on is his posing trunks. It's February. It's freezing out. He can't get into the door. The door locks from the outside. He's got to run around the whole building, go in through the lobby, and run up through the aisle of the auditorium. So when he gets into the auditorium, they announce his name. He runs up the aisle and jumps up on the stage. He comes out there.
That is one of the best stories. Listen to all those stories you've had. That one just.
So the next day, him and his dad are driving home, and his dad's real quiet. And his dad goes, you know, That was pretty cool what you did last night, you know, going through the auditorium and running up the aisle. You can tell him he got locked out. You know?
That was hilarious.
Man. You know, when I first started, my uncle had a friend named Wally Bitter. He was the only guy I knew that had trophies from bodybuilding. So for a short time, I trained with him and my uncle. And, you know, he gave me the whole no carb type thing. And then I realized when I ate carbs after a show, I looked better. So
yeah.
I started going no carb, and then I'd eat carbs, and I learned how to peak for shows.
Right.
But he was from Boyer Coe's area. Like, Boyer Coe was a big fan of his.
Yeah.
He was from Louisiana. He had trophies from, like, 68, 69, maybe 70, 71.
Yeah.
That was an inspiration for me, too, was my uncle's friend.
Okay.
Wally, who's still living, 70-something years old, and still trains and still looks good.
Yeah, yeah.
All these years, I seen him about 2 years ago when my uncle passed.
Really? Wow.
And I'm like, damn, Wally, so good to see you. And it's great that, you know, this guy loves bodybuilding that much.
Keeps the fountain youth, man.
Yeah,
he's still doing it.
He still looks good, and thank him for his help.
Yeah. So speaking of Louisiana, I got to bring this one up because the year I won my class of the America, Jesse Goutreau.
Yeah.
He won a class, Marty Vanekar, Jeff King, but whatever happened to Jesse Goutreau?
I don't know. I haven't heard of him in years.
Have you ever tried to track him down or
no?
He was a good dude, quiet, like all Louisiana, you know, but
yeah.
He was kind of like
He had a good physique.
You probably competed against him, did you?
I don't know if I ever competed against him. I totally know who you're talking about.
Yeah, no, he was a good dude.
I mean, I've seen him. He competed a lot and did well.
Yeah, I just wondered. I don't about
know if I ever been in a show with him, though.
Yeah, because then he's now he's getting south. It just gets me thinking about some of the Florida competitors that might have shown out the America, like Abe Cuesta.
You remember Abe Cuesta? I remember Abe.
He was a funny dude.
Yeah, I competed against him a little bit,
and then
too.
He had Rich Poston.
I just got friends with him today on Facebook.
Did you really?
It was weird. His name came up, and I'm like, you know what? Boom. I clicked on it, and
he was from Tampa. He owned
a gym on Tampa. Oh, yeah. I think I went down and guest posed at a show with him, actually, with Jill O'Connor.
Yeah, from Hammer.
Okay, she won the America when I won.
Did she really the same year? 86?
I'm pretty sure.
I think it was.
No, I think she won 84, Glenn. She won 84.
Oh, yeah, yeah. McCluskey won when I won.
Okay. Connie McCluskey?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, Connie McCluskey.
Right. I couldn't remember her. I couldn't remember. She was actually in
Good
Arizona.
Good thing we got the encyclopedia with us. Damn,
I know, dude.
You're good, bro.
Dude, you're the bomb.
I mean, there's a lot of shit I don't even remember until you guys start bringing it up. And
right, then it comes back. Yeah.
Things start to come back. You know?
Right.
I mean, that's a lot of years ago. And
right.
I entered a lot of damn shows when I was young just because I loved to compete. And
yeah.
I remember Lance telling me, he's like, man, dude, I mean, I didn't have to diet that hard. I dieted like everybody else, but like Lance would have to diet so hard for a show.
Oh, yeah.
So I wonder why you don't like to compete. You know what I mean?
Right.
Dude, I mean, I don't know about you. I hate to say it. You remember, but that was back in the day. If you weren't doing a show, you bulk up.
Yeah.
You know, you get heavy and you get. So I would lose 30 pounds to do a show. It wasn't 30.
Yeah.
See, I tried to get bulk up and all that other stuff. And
your metabolism was too fast.
I mean, I was 10, 15 pounds heavier, maybe, and then I diet down
That's
for a show.
That's why you're always so shredded, man.
Yeah.
I couldn't gain weight. You know, I couldn't seem to get big. I remember being suggested from maybe even Ira that, you should take a year off and try to get bigger. And I liked it too much. I'm like, take no year off. I mean, so I never did. And once I did, I never went back.
Yeah. When you did the America, Larry, that was in Tampa, right?
Yeah.
83. Yeah.
83 in Tampa. And my whole mindset was either I win the show and I go to the universe or I lose and I go to Disneyland. I was either way it was going to be cool. I'd never been to Disneyland or Disney World. I guess
Disney World. Right.
Yeah. But yeah. And that was pretty cool because they took us like as a team and then they set up like a tour. So we got to go, we were there like for 12 days and the funny was, I thought I was, go there and get the food and do the thing. Jeff King shows up. He's got a suitcase full of food. He brought all of them food, and I'm like.
I did that at the America.
Did you? Yeah.
Because I screwed up in 85 on my diet, and I didn't place. And I went back, and a month later, I was in shape, and I stayed like that and all the way till the contest. And when I left my house, I brought my griddle, my microwave, and like my body never knew I left my gym from Phoenix.
Right.
Cooked everything in the hotel. I figured when the show's over, then it's time to do whatever.
Yeah. Where was that at the year you won it, Glenn?
What's that?
Where was the America at the year you won it?
Dallas, Texas. Right?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Okay.
John, I'm impressed.
You won the Mr. World too, right, that year?
That year, the Mr. World was here in Phoenix.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Phoenix or Vegas?
No, I won the AAU Mr. World first.
Oh, that was here. That's right.
Then I won the AAU America in Dallas, Texas.
Okay.
I came back, and I went to the WAB, whatever.
WABA.
The WABA World. That was Vegas. And that's where I thought I achieved probably my best condition. And I won my class, but I lost the overall.
It was at the
guy from Canada, right?
Yeah. Andre Maillet. He was a nice guy.
Yeah.
And then, John, I did wind up going to that IFBB North American Championship 2 years, 89 and 90.
Okay.
89, I lost to that dude too, I think. I don't know if it was the same guy. I lost to some Canadian dude. He had some good shoulders.
That's Andre, yeah.
But I thought, man, all right, that's the only thing that I felt like I needed more of. I couldn't seem to get those caps like some of them guys.
Yeah.
I go back the next year, and I lost to Nimrod King.
Yeah, yeah. And by 1 point, right? 1 point.
Well,
dude, how do you know all this stuff?
Glenn told me. I remember Glenn told me.
Yeah, well, the thing that got me, though, Nimrod King's a great bodybuilder, better one than I am. But that day,
he was off.
He was way off. And I'm like, are you fucking kidding me? He's smooth as shit.
That's what we were talking about.
And I couldn't believe that. I'm like, you hate to sit here, you know, 40 years later and complain, but I just thought it. Then the magazines came out like super quick, and all the pictures from him was from something else, not that day.
Right, right.
I was like, you believe they do are that you crap? Fucking kidding me, man?
You probably know that stuff, John.
Oh, yeah.
We'll get back to our buddy Belknap.
Yeah, let's talk about Belknap.
We're getting, you know, all these years I'd compete against him as a teenager, and he was okay. I think I'd win. He'd take third or fourth or something.
So you knew he was into teenage shows, but not me.
Yeah, I knew he was there.
I don't blame you. I was probably non-existent. He was just kind of a heavy, big dude. He wasn't cut at all.
At that time, he wasn't heavy.
Oh, he wasn't?
He was, you know, he was just an average teenager.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. He was like, he had a teenage body, and he always would take third or fourth.
Mm-hmm.
So then 1 year, I told a couple of my friends that I'm still friends with, dude, let's just go to Kentucky. I want to enter this.
This story.
I entered some damn show in Kentucky. I don't remember the name or nothing.
Yeah.
And I was having a good time weekend, eating pizza, this and that, but not till after the show. I went there and I was in shape, and I wind up taking fourth place. Well, back it up a step. I seen Belknap, and that was the first time he was huge. I'm like, everyone's like, oh my God, you see this guy, you see this. And I didn't even want to let him acknowledge that I noticed.
Yeah, yeah.
I was totally jealous. Like, how the fuck did he get so big?
Well played, yeah.
He was so big, dude. And he had all that shape in the world.
Yeah. And
it was crazy because when we get on stage, he's smooth. But he's so much shaped and he's so big, I don't know what's going to happen.
Yeah.
I take fourth place, they give Belknap fifth.
Oh, no.
He had steam coming out of his ears, man. He was so fucking pissed. And that might have...
He had a temper, man.
That might have drove... Yeah, he was a hothead guy.
Yeah.
That drove him to get cut, come in there, win the Illinois.
Yeah.
Get more fucking ripped, win the Midwest.
Right.
Now he comes and he's totally shredded to beat Lance Dreher.
Yeah.
At the America. Lance was, I don't know whose face had the bigger surprise, Tim or Lance.
Right.
You know, because Tim was like, wow, I actually won this prick.
Yeah.
And Lance was like, are you kidding me? Yeah.
That was a 4-3 vote.
I think Tim was just too ripped.
Yeah.
You know,
he went down to leg heavy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
As great as Lance was, Tim was just.
And what, 5'4"? And he was like, back then, at 198. That size.
Now, Larry, you competed against him at the Junior Illinois, right?
I competed against him numerous times. I want to say someone like a nemesis, but yeah, the Junior Illinois, after I had a great year. And
now that was the first time he was really big, right?
We talked about this when we talked before, just like you were saying, I'm getting all pumped up thinking of all that shit, ready to go on stage and freaking win a Junior Illinois. And here's this Belknap standing in the corner with his velvet sweatsuit on.
Yeah, I was shocked how big he got.
Yeah, but I mean, he wasn't even pumping up. He just standing there.
Yeah.
And I'm thinking he was just kind of a smooth, heavy chunk, whatever. He takes it off.
Did you know who he was, Larry, at that time?
I had no idea.
No idea.
No idea. Never saw him before. I should have just walked. I should have just gone home.
I mean, I knew him. I knew him from the beginning. And like I said, he was fourth here, third here. But when I showed up in Kentucky and he was so freaking big and so shapely, beautiful.
What year was that, Glenn? Was that 82?
Probably 80.
That's when.
Yeah, I think it was 80. Or wait a minute. It was probably 80. Because
that's when he won the Junior Illinois. It was 80.
And then he went on to win the Midwest, what, 81?
81, yeah. And he won the Illinois in November of 80.
And then what was the America? 82, right?
No, 81, later that year.
Oh, 81?
81,
yeah.
Or the same year.
82 was Rufus Howard.
Yeah, yeah.
He won. God, see, I pulled a name.
I seen Tim in four shows, and every one of them was like, he, you know, smooth, big and smooth, but then a little cut. Wow, he's got some cuts here. Now he's ripped, and now the America shredded.
Yeah.
You know, the thing though with Belknap is, didn't he try to go like in the IFBB or NPC or something?
IFBB. Both.
He didn't do well. Right. Something happened. Because man, so he left there, and that's when I ran into him at the NABBA Universe in London in 84 and 85. I took second 2 years in a row. I was like, God damn it. I got to go across the freaking world to lose to a guy who grew up 2 hours from me in Chicago.
Right.
And they're like, again? I'm like, dude, I was thinking, you're supposed to be a pro. How are you even, you know, how are you in this? I was so pissed. Oh, I was so pissed.
Larry, I got that video from that 84 NABBA Universe. I got the prejudging. Well, you know what happened. All these guys walk out, right, Glenn?
In the short I knew class. You were going there.
Whole bunch of guys.
Wait, take the knife out of my back now, bro.
This one hurt. At the very end, and the camera's over here.
How you doing, bro?
My son just came in.
I'm glad, man.
Hello.
How you doing?
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
And so, when they put the camera on.
They got the camera over here. Belknap comes out at the end, and the whole crowd goes, whoa! the camera goes over, and Belknap looks like a freak.
Let's get off here. That is good. From the USA, also, Tim Belknap. Hey there. Anyone want to go away? And finally,
standing right next to him, dude. I was trying to push it. I was thinking, come on, man. Something was wrong with him. I was like, this could be my year, right?
Do you remember that guy, Ron Hagen? Big guy. He used to train with Sergio.
I remember the name. I can't quite put the face to it, though.
He had a mustache. He was a big guy, about 6'2". And, you know, he used to brag to everybody that he trained with. He was Sergio's training partner. So I'm watching the 1980 Mr. Illinois that Belknap won. And I saw the prejudging. I went out there early to Rockford. I watched the prejudging. So then I'm at the night show. And, you know, they got the teenage, and then they got the juniors, and then they got the Mr. This Ron Hagen sitting right behind me with two of his friends. He's ripping on everybody, you know, like, oh, look at this fucking teenager. Can you believe this guy's got no arms? What's he even doing? Like ripping on everybody that came out. So then they have the intermission before they get to the senior class, the open class. He goes out into the lobby and he comes back and he tells his buddies, he goes, hey, you know who I ran into outside? He goes, that kid Belknap, you know, the guy that won the junior Illinois. And I said, hey, Tim, you doing the show? And Belknap looked at him and he goes, I am Mr. Illinois. And he's like, can you believe that guy? What an asshole. You can't fucking say that shit. So then Belknap comes out. This fucker didn't say a word. The rest of the night, he didn't say one word. His mouth was hitting the floor.
That was Tim, though, man.
Yeah, oh, he was unbelievable that day.
Oh, yeah. That's funny. Grab a beer, dude. Oh,
yeah, good stuff, John.
Yeah,
John, I'm impressed. It's like you just come from the gym after a day of work, 9:30 your time. You're still rolling.
What did we talk for, an hour and a half?
Something like that.
Yeah,
it's fun, man.
Yeah,
Chicago.
So, who was the most impressive bodybuilder you guys ever saw? Was it Sergio, Glenn, for you?
As far as being in person, Sergio.
Yeah.
And he wasn't shabby on the stage either.
Right.
77, 78. But as far as somebody being on stage, I would have to say probably McAway and Zane.
Okay.
Those two guys I saw, I was just like, man, it was just such a show to watch, you know?
Did you see those guys in person, Glenn, at a show?
Yeah.
What show? Do you remember?
Well, it wasn't a show. They were both guest posing.
Oh, guest posing. Okay.
Guest posing in great shape.
Yeah, yeah.
I was just like, man, these guys, Muhammad with his posing routine, phenomenal.
I know. Nobody poses like that today. Nobody.
No, it was just insane.
Yeah.
And Zane a couple times in great shape. I'm trying to think I hope I'm not leaving anybody out. I mean, obviously, if I am, it's because I didn't see him.
Yeah.
You know, I've always been a great fan of Samir and Labrada.
Samir was impressive. He won the 85, that pro world, at the Wobble World.
Yeah, he looked amazing that year.
You're talking about impressive. I mean, he was freak. Sergeant Bray was incredible. I got to train and stay at his place.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, big fan of his, but I never got to see him, you know?
Right, me neither.
Oh, no, that was like kind of a luckout type of thing. But, you know, talk about – he wasn't like the most impressive physique, but entertaining as hell. John Brown.
Oh yeah.
Remember his robotic routine back in the 80s? Oh my God, people went nuts.
Yeah.
Speaking of John
Brown, I could watch him over and over. You get it, bro? You watch him over and over. He was.
So you saw him in Europe, right, Larry? When he was out there doing the guest posings?
Oh yeah, we went around together a fair amount.
Yeah. Right. Right.
I mentioned we would go to lunch at McDonald's and I'd bring my potato and chicken breast and he'd order Big Mac and fries and shit. Right. And he goes, he had to eat like that or he'd be a
leave him, man. He'd just eat whatever he wanted. And speaking of John Brown, his son's was a great college football player. I don't know if he's still.
Oh yeah.
I think one of his sons one of his sons plays for the Packers, I think.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
But he changed his last name.
Yeah.
It's called St. Brown or something.
St. Brown. Right. Right.
Yeah. Yeah. I remember the interview, but then I saw him on TV. I go, wait, that's John Brown's kid, man.
Yeah.
Yeah. I was watching the college game and they said his dad's a bodybuilder. I'm like, oh shit, I know who he is. You know what I mean?
Yeah, right.
You know, John, your interviews and stories, it's so cool.
Yeah, thank you.
Stuff you've delved into that, you know, I don't know about you, Glenn. I never, you know, like knew these guys' stories and the way they train and what they went through. Like,
it's
cool, man. I just want to thank you for what you're doing, because
thank you.
Who else has? You've got the passion, and I just like you've crushed it.
I love it too, man. I love talking to those guys. You know, I wish I
figured you'd have to, because you know,
it just shocks me like how many you were able to reach.
Yeah,
it says, you know, who haven't you got to yet?
Right.
I mean, I see stuff with you and Tom Platz and Samir and, you know, so many of the greats. And I'm like, all right, if I ever got to meet any of them, it was just like, hi, I'm Glenn. I'm competing in this local fucking teenage thing.
Right. Right.
And I watch him guest pose, but I do have to say, like Frank Zane, Boyer Coe, there was a few of them that were just so freaking kind and polite to me.
Yeah.
When I was younger, and I thought, wow, these guys, this is what I want to be like, you know?
Right.
I want to be one of these big shot guys and be nice to kids, you know?
Right.
Whatever.
Right. Yeah, Boyer's a great guy.
I remember Frank Zane. I'm sure I'm missing a few, but damn, Larry's son's bigger than him, dude.
He's giant. Say hi, Cole.
Maybe we should get him out of the interview.
Oh, hi, man.
No, wait a minute. No, we got to take points
off. Here's the next level, John. John's
there we go.
Hey, John, we got to take points off. He got tattoos, bro.
Oh, yeah.
They allow tattoos.
Not no more, Glenn. Not no more.
Back the day later, nobody had tattoos.
Oh, yeah, no one
can't see anything.
If you had a beard, you freaking.
Yeah, the AAU would tell you to shave it off.
Right.
Which I had no problem doing. Okay. Oh, that was the.
I got to step out. Three beers. I got to break the seal.
All right. Yeah, I'll be after him. So. Yeah, good stuff, John.
I talked to Jerry Branham. You remember Jerry Branham, Glenn? He used to write for the magazines.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's a good interview. But he was talking about Ron Tufel. Remember Ron Tufel had that tattoo on his shoulder?
Right, he had a small one. I remember.
Yeah, a small one, like an eagle or something. And so he tried to get it removed. This is back in the probably late 70s, early 80s. And he said it was like his skin got all fucked up. You know, it was like all puffy and shit, you know. Remember when they tried to remove the tattoos back then? They didn't have it, you know, they didn't have that process finalized.
You know, I thought about it when I was a young kid, and then my dad was like, what? Are you kidding me? And
yeah.
So I never did. And then once I started competing, I never wanted any. So
Right.
And now to this day, I see a lot of bodybuilders that are done competing.
Yeah.
Even like John Defendis. He went and got a couple tattoos.
Oh, he did?
Yeah, I thought I seen tattoos on him. I'm like, why would you do that now after all these years?
Yeah.
He's his own, don't get me wrong.
Right.
They look great on other people, but I'm glad I don't have any, man.
Yeah, me too. Nowadays, man, they get the whole arm. They don't just get one tattoo.
That's what,
they get the sleeve.
Corey, right?
Cole.
That's what Larry's son Cole's got, the whole arm here.
Yeah, man. There you go.
I had my girlfriend Kathy. She put a little one on the back of her neck. Her three daughters have them. I'm like, all right, she's like 55 or something. Like, why now would you get this little tattoo?
Right.
I don't get it, but it looks great, honey. You know.
Yeah.
Well, what are you gonna do, man?
Right.
All right, Larry, you're up.
I'm sorry, dude.
I know. Go in there and take a leak myself. Like, if I can get up.
How many times in an interview have you had this, John? That's what happens when you interview old guys with messed up process.
Right.
Take a right down the hall. Oh, he's asking you, where's the bathroom at? Oh, my God. It's so funny.
How many, you've been out there for like, what, 25 years now, Larry?
I've been out here like since 86.
So yeah, holy shit.
Yeah, yeah, I came out here to train with Lance and
never left. I know.
It's been good, you know? It's been good. I just wish there was some type of hardcore place like everyone can go back and get together and be like the old times. And
Yeah.
You know, watch some freaks come out of the gym and play high nationals.
Right.
And not freaks like, you know, we were talking about, but like classic freaks.
Yeah.
Like maybe my son. Like, you know who impressed me is Leo Rabada's kid.
Yeah, he's huge.
Yeah, but I mean, but he's not like stupid. Like, you know what I mean? I hate to say stupid. Yeah. And he looked good. I was like, well done, Lee.
Yeah. It'll be interesting to see what he looks like in the next couple of years. I wonder if I better keep getting bigger though, you know?
Yeah. I'm not a fan of that look. I hate to say it.
I know. And his posing was pretty good, but I thought it was going to be a little bit better, you know?
Yeah.
Not as good as his dad's.
Yeah, I like that Sean Ray routine you threw up there from back in the day.
Yeah, yeah.
That was like, I had never seen that because, you know, maybe being a few years older than that crowd.
Yeah.
And was looking back and.
The one where he won the Nationals?
Yeah.
Yeah.
He was trained by John Brown, right?
Yep, yeah. John Brown taught him how to pose.
Yeah, I was like, oh, yeah. Yeah, because that whole, all that stuff.
Yeah, I think John Brown helped out Sean, Vince Taylor, and Melvin Anthony. They're all awesome posers.
Oh, yeah. And that was like kind of ahead of their time, right?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, for sure.
Yeah. Yeah. And I was like, man, I wish we had something like that in Chicago.
Right. Helping us. Right.
Bunch of white boys with no rhythm.
Right.
Help, man. I mean, and we weren't Sergio Leiva. We couldn't just get on stage and go, oh, yeah, he's that. You know what I mean?
Right. It's like, well, we were all pretty good posers, though. I mean, at least we tried, you know?
Oh, yeah. But our routine. But just say that stuff, like, oh, you're talking about McAway and all that. It's like, you try to emulate it. You know what I mean? You saw it and it was like, oh, I want to look like that. You know,
right,
he had that thing and all that.
Right,
like,
right.
Yeah, but he had, man, a special presence about him.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Amazing.
I was so impressed when I saw that dude.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. And he was just a little dude.
Yeah.
There wasn't much to him at all. I mean, I saw him in photo next to Sable. You know, I saw him, Mike had some posts and some pictures. Like, walked on there, met McAway, and I would have loved to.
Yeah.
But he's like, wow, he's not that big a dude at all.
That's what's missing from our sport.
Other guys, guest posts here in Phoenix, you know, and they were good. Like, you know, Haney and some other greats, but McAway and Zane, dude, I don't know.
Yeah.
Even like Boyer Coe, I seen him a few times, totally in great shape. I mean, he had those special arms and
signature poses.
Yeah, but it, you know, he had a weird midsection, like he didn't have abs at all.
Right, right.
You know, not to take anything away from him, but you knew when you seen that body who it was.
Yeah,
Boyer Coe.
Yeah. Well, I remember they used to do the Olympia, and they would have the stage backlit, so when the guys came out, you could only see their silhouette.
Yeah, the silhouettes.
And they would come out and hit one pose, and the whole crowd would know who that guy was, you know?
Yeah, and as great as he was, like, he could never beat a Zane.
No, he never beat Zane.
It's 10 o'clock here, bro. I'll be snoring. I don't care. You can stay out here and party. I don't care. I'm going to be snoring like a big dog. I was up at 4:15 this morning.
I'm going to be at the bar looking for a new girlfriend. See what I can find. I actually did meet one last week.
Oh, yeah. I'll
meet her tomorrow.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, we'll see what happens.
Look at you two freaking stud muffins, man. I'm just living through you guys, you know? We waited like 25, 30 more minutes. My wife will come home from the hospital. Oh, you drunk bastards.
Right. All right, John. Yeah, great.
All right, guys. Well, I'll let you guys go. Thank you for joining me on the Bodybuilding Legends podcast. I had a great time talking to you.
Thanks for having us.
I'll have to do it again one day.
I hope so.
All right, John. Good
to
see you.
I think we want to interview you, though. I want to interview you.
All right. I'm up for it. I'll be drinking a beer.
There we go.
See you, John.
All right.
All right, guys. Good seeing you, man. Take care.